we are introducing Vlogmas this year with Heart Christmas. I mean, if I'm in the car and it's December, it can only mean one thing, and that is Christmas music. So I hope you guys are all well. I wanted to kind of just firstly introduce today's video with a bit of a rundown of, hopefully, fingers crossed, what I'll plan on doing throughout December. So I know November was a haul heavy month, especially with like my gift guides and things, and I know a lot of you love that content, and it's kind of like suited, I think anyway, to November because of the gifting season and people thinking about Christmas shopping. I'm sure a lot of you have, if not started, finished your shopping by now. Now that it is December, now that I'm starting, not quite, but starting to just take things a little bit easier after the madness of November that is in this industry with Black Friday, gift guides, all of that kind of content, it gets hectic. So yeah, it feels quite nice to just maybe vlog and enjoy December a bit more, get into the festive groove with the hopefully Christmas markets, gift wrapping, tablescaping, hosting as well this year, because that is what we're doing, which I'm so excited for. So really getting prepped for Christmas. We want to maybe get a real tree for in the kitchen as well. So Vlogmas is here. The plan is to hopefully throughout December stick to my usual upload of Sundays and Wednesdays and just make them Vlogmas episodes. So vlogging over whether it be a day, a couple of days, whatever it may be, but being a bit more vlog heavy this month. So I hope you guys enjoy that. There will of course be hauls and stuff within the videos as and when I'm shopping, which is where I'm heading off to today. I'm going to Cheshire Oaks this afternoon. I was gonna say this morning. It's actually winding down to sun setting. I don't know if you can tell by that light, it's like directly in my eyes, but it's about 3 o'clock. I'm gonna go over to Cheshire Oaks. They are hosting an evening of festivities. We've got the dog in tow. Barney is with us because I think tonight is fairly relaxed. Rather than like an organized event, it's more a case of we say hello, we have a look at the Christmas display section, they've got foodie bits, we get some food vouchers, we can just basically say hello to them and then just have a bit of a wander around the center. I'll obviously take you guys with me, see what is there. I want to go a little bit earlier though and head via, hopefully, we'll see how we get on with time, but Neptune, Chester, and Inspirations Wholesalers, both of which are also dog friendly, and both of which will probably have their festive Christmassy bits out as well. Well, they will. I know they will. Both of them. They've probably had them out since October. Well, especially Inspirations. But that's the plan today. En route out, I was given a parcel. Shall I open it with you now or shall we wait till we get home? So it's from QVC. So I've literally just, because I kind of crossed paths with the postman, I said, oh, I'll just take it. Ooh, from L'Occitane. Ah, this is delayed. This won't be relevant to you guys anymore, but L'Occitane, great for Christmas gifting as well. But they've got this on QVC, or they had this on QVC. I don't know if they'll still have it, but a little gift set with them, of which they've got all of these goodies in. The almond shower oil, which is always lovely. Hands and body Neroleon Orchidée. And then we've also got a rich body lotion and a cute little festive edition of the hand cream. This is the almond and flowers. I wonder if this is a new scent, almond and flowers. Let's buckle up. Let's get Heart Xmas back on and let's get on the road. Let's head over to Cheshire Oaks via the other shops and kickstart Vlogmas 2023, which is so exciting. Any other recommendations of your favorite YouTubers that you like to watch their Vlogmas episodes, let me know in the comments below, because I'm always on the hunt for some Vlogmas series to watch throughout December. Let's go shopping. So much for a slick back bun do today, seeing as though it's quite blustery out there. All my hair is coming out a bit.
even with all the hairspray. Such a pretty sunset.
Anyway, popped in to Neptune. I've just finished in there. Some gorgeous little Christmas bits out. Obviously, it wasn't too long ago that I was at the Neptune outlet, of which they definitely had different stock. And also, look, new Potter's Pink bag again. But also, they do these mini versions in Potter's Pink and Walnut. So I got the Walnut one. Cute. My fun tree, the one that we get to put up in the kitchen, but some kind of nostalgic baubles, felt baubles. It's not the glam white company style tree, it's the other tree. I am actually more excited to decorate that than I was the, I kind of am like looking forward to that one a bit more because I can be a bit more fun with it. And anyway, I got, that's the most ugly thing ever when just one strand falls out like that. Ugh. Anyway, I got these one of these new Neptune bands that they have, these baubles in the Potter's Pink. Now, I'm not a big lover of the Potter's Pink colour, to be honest with you, but for my little nostalgic tree, I thought a little Neptune band like this would just be a nice little addition to the tree. I would have preferred it if it was like a green, maybe. Who knows? If they bring out a green next year, we might add to the collection of Neptune bands. But then I also got a couple of other bits. I also got, where are we? There's one, there's two. I've got two of these little candle holders because I thought, seeing as they were hosting this year, I thought on the tablescape it'd be quite nice to have some sort of church candles, just thin ones. And these are only £5 each and I love these little stands. I do have some taller candlestick holders, like brass ones, but I thought a little ceramic stars, and like their little houses that they do, they're more of a off-white kind of distressed looking rather than sort of an imperfect finish rather than a perfectly clean white ceramic. They also have in that range these, is there a name for the range, Ripley, they do these ceramic trees. So they do bigger ones, I think medium ones, and then they do this size, which I thought would be really nice for somehow maybe keeping this on it and having it as like a little bauble on the tree. Oh, I don't know how I'm gonna, yeah, I could do a little jute ribbon around that top part, tie it up and then do a loop off that so that it's a bauble on the fun tree or even the nice tree, or just standing alone, obviously with a little Christmassy scene. We do have time to pop over to Inspirations Wholesalers, so let's head there next. Just in case you're wondering what I'm wearing today, I've just got a bit cozy with a scarf. This is the one that I got for Christmas last year from Burberry. This is like my main present. And then this blazer's that herringbone one that I got from the collection that Lydia did with an AKD, or Naked Fashion. I feel like I'm slacking. I feel tired this afternoon, so I feel like a festive hot chocolate or coffee or something is in order. Thought I'd just do a quick voiceover arriving at Inspirations Wholesale, because every time I come I seem to get quite a few questions from you guys, and they essentially are a wholesalers, but you don't have to be a business owner or anything like that. Oh god, look at that decor. Honestly, they go all out at Christmas. But anyway, as I was saying, you don't need to have a specific membership that you have to pay for or anything like that. It's just at checkout. You just basically have to give your postcode and set up an account if you haven't got one already, but it's free to do. But yeah, thought I would just mention that before heading over to the gorgeous Christmas scenes over at Cheshire Oaks. Honestly, guys, super, super festive, in my absolute element. We have just arrived, haven't we, Barney? And they've very kindly given us, obviously, I can see, a white chocolate teddy from Lindt. Amazing. And then in here we've got some like drinks vouchers. We could go on a ride, however, I'm not sure you'd be allowed. but what I might do is use the food token to get some dinner. I'm trying to suss out, but I think I'm going to go for the carvery option. They've also got cheese, chutney, pancakes over there, and also the mousse bar for drinks. Got all the Christmas tunes on still. or someone's just about to come in here, but I've just grabbed some churros, so I'm gonna have this, then get home and show you in the daylight what I got, which actually isn't too much. Yeah, I got some bits from Inspirations Wholesalers and then just some Hotel Chocolat bits actually. But yeah, lovely little family friendly type thing with the rides and stuff, and didn't go on a ride, seeing as I had a dog and I was by myself, but maybe next time.
Well, this is the coziest setup I ever did see. Sat by the tree on the carrot and I didn't even know it.
Hello guys, good morning. It's a new day and I got up this morning. I thought I would share with you the bits that I got from Cheshire Oaks. Careful, Barney. We don't want you delving into the coffee. Ooh, that's hot, 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 hot. Just gonna pop that up there out of his way. Yeah, so I thought I'd show you the bits that I got. I definitely am eager to show you because there's some bits in there that I want to start eating, but I thought I would save it for this part of the video. And then what else have we got planned today? We might go and do a beach walk, a nice wintry beach walk in Lytham. We often, well, Formby we've been to before and that's lovely, but also Lytham St Anne's quite often go to. So we might do a beach walk. I kind of want to do some Christmas planning as well, potentially a bit of organization, maybe even pop up the wreath and the garland. I don't know whether to do the garland yet because obviously we've only just freshly had our banister painted, and I don't know if, I mean, it's obviously been long enough that it's dry, but is it safe to pop a wreath in it? Oh, I just don't know. I just don't know. But anyway, I'm going to start with, first and foremost, the fact that Cheshire Oaks very kindly invited us down. So they are fairly local to us, only about half an hour or so. So I said, yeah, I'll pop down. I'll have a look at your Christmas new in bits. They also gave us this little teddy bear, the lint, white lint chocolate. Delicious, probably my favorite white chocolate, and a gift card. So I put that gift card towards a couple of bits. I feel like I'm a bit low now. I knew that was gonna happen.
Hotel Chocolat.
So I've got three more of these crackers, so we've got enough for Christmas Day, because I have decided we've got the fun cracker, but then it's always nice to have the luxury cracker as well. So I've gone overboard and bought two crackers for everyone for Christmas Day. And also we've got the mini Hotel Chocolat ones, which I bought previously, which will go in like a gift bag. Oh my God, I need to, I can't set my feet like that, I get pins and needles. So that's that. I also stocked up on their offer, three for, these are what I want to delve into today. Three for, I wanna say £12 it is, maybe, three for 12. But they've got the cafe latte ones there, which, unpopular opinion, I enjoy coffee chocolate. And then the pistachio praline one, dizzy pralines. These are really good. And then I also got a couple of these boxes, great for gifting. Again, the winter puddings set and the classic Christmas. These are the H boxes that they do. They do them all year round, the H boxes, but the Christmas edition ones are great for a good little gift. But if you want a dupe version, Aldi do them. It's not a H on the front, but it basically looks like it, and the chocolates are very similar. They do like a puddings edition, a alcohol edition, so it's literally just like the Hotel Chocolat. But they do quite a few dupes, actually, Hotel Chocolat dupes in Aldi. And then something else in there is another gift, which, yeah, I don't really want to show because it's not my gift to give, so I will leave that in there for now. But yeah, Hotel Chocolat is always worth checking out when you go to Cheshire Oaks, because you can grab yourself a bargain. Inspirations Wholesalers, I did come out with a little box full of goodies. So first thing is these to pop on the Christmas tree. Now these work so strong and so well that when we got out the Balsam Hill tree, which drops that, a load of you have asked actually which tree this is. I think it's the Vermont spruce, it's called, in 7.5 foot, 7.5 foot, and it's from Balsam Hill. Such a lovely tree. But when we got it out of its packaging, bearing in mind we didn't decorate with this tree last year, if you remember, if you've been here, renovations, you'll know. So 2 years ago we had these on the tree. We got it out and we could still smell them. They've got loads of different scents, but I get the winter white winter fir ones, just because I think simple. But they do like orange and cinnamon and everything. Oh yeah, I forgot I got this. I got this bauble, which I'm gonna pop straight on the tree at £2.25. It's a really pretty
kind of frosted looking pine cone with a nice brass topper. And what else did I get? I also got this for our, probably for our fun tree, this one, which we're gonna do on our kitchen. Or maybe within the next video or two, next Vlogmas or two, you'll be able to see that. But £1.49, they had different color sledges, of which I got the white one that just says Merry Christmas with a little bell and like sprig of something on there. And then also these, again, as a bit of like a fun decoration, £1.99. They had these ones in white fur with the brown ski poles and then the reverse. And this just reminds me of when we did the cross country skiing in Finland this year. I got some ribbon, of which I think these were about £3 to £5 each, depending on the size that you get. But I went for some simple green like ribbon, really, really pretty for gift wrapping. And then we also got a couple of Santa Paws gifts to go straight in a stocking, of which this one was $5.99. Oh, I just feel like he knows. Why do dogs just know when it's a dog toy for them? I'm just trying to do this so carefully. But anyway, yeah, it's all crinkly and obvious that it's a dog toy. And then also this cute little polar bear. Oh, I love him. This one was a bit more expensive. This one was £8.25. But I just think the way that he sits like that, so cute. It has got a squeaker in there as well. And then a couple of other baubles to add to the tree. We've got this one at £2.49, and it's a little, I thought, quite white company style because they have a lot of hearts, don't they? Just plain glass. Does it open? It does open. We could put something in there maybe. Even a little like mini Polaroid photo would be cute in there. But yeah, I was thinking chocolates then, but I've got some nostalgic chocolates for the chocolate, for the fun tree in the kitchen, because we, our Christmas trees were never complete without maybe a cracker thrown in there, a couple of hanging chocolate decorations. So yeah, I've got them for the kitchen tree. And then these two, which are kind of from the same line, but just different shapes. So we've got a star, if I can just get the label right, the right way around. Actually, yeah, they were both £1.25 each. So we've got a star and a snowflake. Yeah, that's what I picked up on my little venture out. I feel like we're going to venture back out now, but to the beach this time, and then crack on with some last bits of Christmas kind of prep and organise. Last bits. Who am I kidding? I'm only just getting started, I feel. Honestly, there's just so much to do at Christmas, isn't there? The madness and the Christmas rush around Black Friday, end of November into early December is just crazy. It's crazy. Crazy, crazy times, especially working in this industry, but I'm definitely not complaining. I'm just fully in the Christmas zone, Christmas spirit, and I'm going to enjoy the rest of that coffee with some chocolates.
Your eyes, get some rest. I'm by your side. Lay your head on my chest. I know you've had a really bad day.
Hello. I've just realised I had some other bits that I wanted to share with you, which I totally forgot. Oh my god. this just arrived in the post. This is something I wasn't going to show you, but a reality into who I am as a person. The real me. Are you ready for this? So she's pretty big, but it's from Amazon, and I've ordered this puzzle table. Essentially, it is wooden, so it's got like a wooden frame whereby you can open these side panels out. I think it's a 1500 piece size, but it's just really good for this sort of a house when I like to do a puzzle at this time of the year, that I can fold it away, fold the legs down, and then they just like slide under a sofa. So I'll probably even just keep it in there and just slide it under the sofa. Oh, I don't know if I've shown you our new banister yet. All black, guys. Well, not all black,
black handrails and posts. What do we think? We just used the Lick Black O2, which was left over from the paint that we used in this room. And I think this year, oh, as much as I want to, and who knows, I might end up changing my mind, but I think I might keep the banister free from decoration just because it is freshly painted, and I just want to avoid any marks or anything like that. And the only other option I might do is, rather than put it around the handrail, I might pop it along here, like hanging down here somewhere, or weaving in between here. I'm not sure. If you see it, you see it. If you don't this year, you don't. There are a couple of other bits. I'm getting sidetracked now, but a couple of other bits that I popped out on these shelves, which I thought I'd show you for decorations, which I didn't really show in my Decorate for Christmas video with me, Decorate with Me for Christmas, just purely because I hadn't done it yet. But quick overview, we've got a little Fireside and Embers candle from Sainsbury's. We've got some little mini houses, reindeers. These are all from like last year as well, little pine cone there. I think the reindeer was from The Range, and I can't remember the houses. Also, that wreath as well was from, I've had that for a few years. It's chapter 13 of Prisoner of Azkaban, if you were interested. All crumpled up into a beautiful little book wreath. And then we've got some stars on top, some wooden stars. Again, these are all previous years, so I can't really remember where everything's from. But we've got this wooden tree at the top. That was Home Sense, I remember that. A little black nutcracker, which I got from America, actually. But I think you can buy them in, well, no, you can get them in Home Sense places like that. Little trees as well. Got this candle, I actually pulled this one out from last year, I didn't get around to burning it, but it's white balsam. And then again, another little house, I think that one was the charity shop, actually. I think I remember that was Home Sense as well. That house, I think, was a bargain, like a B&M type place. And then we've got this star, this beaded star. These always remind me of the White Company because they're beaded. It is a hanging one, but I've just popped the hanging side behind the photo frame so you can't see it. A little Sainsbury's candle in that fir balsam as well. These are Hobbycraft, these two little houses, because they're the sort of texture that you can paint, but I just like them kept nice and white. And then again, a little pine cone sat with that. I did show you me popping that potpourri out. That's the fir tree one from the White Company, and guys, it smells lovely. And then just a couple of little touches down there, which is going to be switched out for the tree. Couple of tea towels, which were from Matalan last year. I'm not sure if they have them this year or not, but yeah, they were Matalan last year. I showed you the bells, but I also found this little Christmas candle. I popped out a couple of Christmas books, this Advent one, recipes and crafts for the countdown to Christmas, and the Tanya Burr Tanya's Christmas as well. And then over this side, we've just added a little ceramic tree. Oh, and then of course the glass tree from The Range, which I've just popped a selection of Quality Street, Celebrations and Heroes. And then I had a couple of these as well, so I've just popped them in there. Little tea caddy, tea bag thing there in a star shape, and that's that. I did switch out our soap recently as well, which, sorry, the drains are making funny noises. It's because the dishwasher's on. But you may remember I had a block of soap here which had gone a bit gross, if I'm honest with you, because it had been used, half used, and I ended up scrapping it, getting rid. And then you may recognize this as a little kind of DIY gift option for Christmas from my B&M gift guide, where I did some DIY options too. And I've just popped my little White Company soap. This is in Sea Salt. I don't know if they do any kind of festive additions in the soaps, but anyway, we probably won't get around to using it that much. It's more for show, really. Well, not for show, but people can use it. But I just use the Daylesford Farm one, which this bottle brush is also from Daylesford Farm. A little linen towel. This little brush is from Sostrine Gren. And that's that. And then lastly, on the little console behind the table, we've got some candle snuffer, antique brass, although they can be out all year round, some little pine cones, fir tree botanical candle, and then down here, another one of Barney's hairs, another little house. This is like an oil burner one, actually. Popped some bells here, but I might pop those on the end of the staircase, actually, if I use a garland. And then lastly, a little tree candle. Again, this one I pulled out from last year, which I didn't get around to burning, but it's in fresh cut pine. But yeah, they're not the bits that I was gonna show you. I was gonna show you a couple of bits that I got from, this is turning out to be haul heavy. I know I said November was haul heavy. We're gonna do more vlogs. It's vlog style, but it's still haul heavy. So apologies. I've just been, whoa, it's bright out there. Such a gorgeous day today.
I've just been so busy shopping for Christmassy bits that I just want to share them all with you guys. So Sainsbury's, some bits from Sainsbury's. Oh, mind you, I did get myself some Amazon bits as well. Go grab another tea, guys. Grab a tea, get comfy, and let's show you some more bits. I'll show you these as well, because why not? Wasn't going to. Was just going to do an Instagram reel, but I appreciate not everyone on here has Instagram or like is religious on following Instagram, and vice versa. So I will still do the Instagram for those of you like that like the Instagram reel content, but for those of you that prefer the YouTube world, I will share everything else with you now. So Amazon, I've got the thing that arrived, the puzzle table. Might do some gift wrapping in my next Vlogmas video because I want to get started nice and early, be prepared. And I feel like within those videos, if you've missed any kind of gift guide content or things that I've been showing in vlogs, you might get some more gift ideas. But I just love, I've been finding people's gift wrapping videos really therapeutic. So anyway, Amazon, let's start with Amazon, seeing as though I've just shown you that puzzle table. So I just got a couple of books. Love a good book purchase on Amazon. Firstly, this. I will save all of these to my Amazon storefront if you want to just easily shop any of my Amazon recommendations over on there. Then you can do that. My makeup looks very minimal today. I didn't realize how minimal I went. But anyway, the Daily Stoic. I didn't realize quite how it was set out, but now I've got it, I quite like it. But it's 366 meditations on wisdom, perseverance, and the art of living. So I didn't realize it was literally meditation a day. So they're all dated. And it's not necessarily a meditation, but it's more a passage, like a paragraph or two that you can read through. Maybe just reflect upon, have a think. It's slightly, not slightly, it is kind of religion-based, which I don't really talk about religion, politics, or anything like that on this channel, because I just like to keep things nice and lighthearted. Same with what's going on in the news and everything like that. We all know, so I like to have platforms as a bit of an escapism. If you need to just relax and unwind, that's why I don't really talk about political things, religious things. But I'm not personally, I've kind of been brought up Christian. We've been to church. I went to Methodist school, but we don't go to church anymore. I do have a Bible, but I don't research. I'm more agnostic, I would say. Open to it. And we're just probably going to leave it at that at this stage. But I don't practice religion. I appreciate the values and the morals of a lot of religious. I'm going to stop talking about it now because I just don't want to go into this. I need to shut them blinds. I'm just opening them and it's a bit chaotic, isn't it? So just like as an example, February 8th, did that make you feel better? And then there's a bit of an extract. So it's, you cry, I'm suffering severe pain. Are you then relieved from feeling it if you bear it in an unmanly way? So then it sort of runs you through the next time someone gets upset near you or crying, yelling, breaking something, being pointed or cruel, watch how quickly this statement will stop them cold. I hope this is making you feel better. And then it goes on. But anyway, it's something that you can just kind of have a bit of a daily reflection upon and then do with that what you will. Workstead, interiors of beauty and necessity. I thought that one looked lovely. This one was my favorite one. I thought the color of this is just gorgeous. It's like a rich olive kind of color. And it's called Portraits of Home Disc Interiors. And then last but not least for books, I got this one, The Foraged Home. Now I've seen this one in TK Maxx and Home Senses before. And yeah, I just thought it was a really nice one to have a flick through. So I've got another one of those. Guys, I need more books. Need is a strong word, but with the shelving in the other room, there's a lot more places to style up than I've ever had before. The shelves in here, it's just all very much styling purposes. I love a book and I just feel like I can never have too many. I feel like I want to share with you these other bits, but I feel like the lighting is really rubbish. I think I'm gonna just take you through to the kitchen actually. Let's share with you the Sainsbury's bits. I'm gonna share with you the first thing that I saw. They've got some gorgeous homeware bits, by the way, some beautiful antique bells, which I'm yet to find in my store, but keep my eyes peeled. Well, I did get some. Why am I just on such a tangent? I feel like I start something and then I'm moving on to the next thing already. I haven't even finished the last thing, but I'll just show you, seeing as though I just mentioned the bells. How cute are they? Hanging bells swag. So it's a little swag with a like a burgundy bow, which I do have touches of red, especially I'm going to have more in this room when the new tree's up. But this is the first thing that I saw. Oh no, there's something on it. I've got some dirt on it. But a letter writing set, 20 luxury handmade paper sheets, olive envelopes with a gold brushed pen. I just thought that was such a lovely little gift set, especially if you're the sort of person that likes to do thank you cards or letters to people that buy gifts at Christmas. I know in my B&M gift guide as well, I mentioned a little gift jar with some date night ideas, maybe 12 different date night ideas that you can pull from a jar throughout the year, maybe once a month. They could go on this maybe, and I can wrap that up and give it a little gift to Tom. But anyway, I also got these felted, let me talk prices actually, because I hate it when I watch these videos back and I've forgotten to tell you the prices. The hanging bells were £5 and the large ones that I've seen online are only 10. So yeah, worth checking out. And then the letter writing set, I need to sneeze. The letter writing set was £10. And then yeah, these little felt stars, £6, pound each. How cute are they? They're actually quite like baby-like almost. You know, if you had a little nursery or a kid's room with a kid's tree, and that would be cute to have. And then I got this brass gold kind of beaded star I just thought would look nice on our main tree. I also got these tree decorations. So I wanted to find some Cadbury ones and I couldn't, but these are quite fun too. They're just giving 90s nostalgia, Christmas, growing up as a child. If I see some Cadbury ones, I'll probably buy them too. And these will all go on the fun tree in the kitchen. But yeah, I thought I would pick these ones up. I think there's about 8 different chocolates in there. Quite big ones as well. Those Santas are just so nostalgic. I want to find, I saw some in HomeSense actually, I might buy them, but loads of little mini Santas wrapped up like that, just to, and then just have like a bowl of them. Yeah. Anyway, I also got some festive marshmallows that they do. I didn't realize, I thought they were all snowflakes, but I've just seen, I think some of them are little snowmen. Oh, that's what that is. That's annoying. I can see what it is that's leaked now. Anyway, I also got these. Just forgot to put them away, but might as well show you them. They are brand new from Foxes, hazelnut flavored, creamy, indulgent. And then some gorgeous gift wrap options. Beautiful design, very simple. It's just like a scripted Merry Christmas. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. So I've got two of these bags at, how much were they? £2 each. And then, oh, we got some festive edition shortbread. I love the box of this anyway. I thought this just sat out if we're hosting or whatever, just to have, you know, once people are having a nice tea or coffee, to have some biscuits, some shortbread. But festive edition ones, I think they were £5 as well, £5 or £6. And then I just saw this at checkout and I thought, I'm just gonna grab it for myself, for no one else but me. I might even get a selection of Christmas magazines actually to pop out somewhere, because I just feel like, again, I might pop them on the footstool so that people, when they're out for Christmas, you can just have a flick through, especially the Times, Radio Times. We like a scribble on the page of highlighting what we want to watch on Christmas. But yeah, this is just a festive edition word search book, which I am a puzzler, as you can tell by that puzzle table. Why am I looking at myself in this viewfinder? Does my nose look red? Because I haven't blown my nose. It's weird. I look like Rudolph. Strange. Anyway, Sostrine Green. I popped into the Altrincham store yesterday and had a good look around and picked up some bits. So I thought I would share them with you. We have in here, I'm gonna whiz through these, try to. A Little House, this one was £4.70 and they had bigger ones as well. These do light up though. The main reason why I went in was to pick up some church candles just for the tablescaping for Christmas. I've got a couple of green ones, a couple of white tall and then white short ones as well. They're about 80p each, 60 to 80p. In fact, no, I think the smaller ones are only 40p. At checkout, I saw these beige candy canes, which I'm not a candy cane person, but for decoration on the tree, I think these would look lovely, especially on the fun tree. Or even on the other tree, actually, because they're beige. I just thought they were lovely. Or wrapped up with presents, if you've got like a nice big box and you're doing a big bow, to tuck that in. If your colour theme is fairly neutral. These were about £1 each. Everything in Sostra is very reasonably priced, I will say that. Again, just a couple of pounds each these ones were, and they are little napkin rings in a festive holly shape, and they're in like an antique brass. So I got eight of these. Even though we're not hosting eight this year, there's only five of us on actual Christmas Day, I thought these will come in handy in future years and we can keep them and reuse them again and again. Oh yeah, these were fun finds. So they have these like stamps and stamp sections, of which I got a couple of ink pads. I got a festive burgundy red and then a neutral beige colour. So again, on white paper, this would look lovely. But I got two different designs. One very festive, which is a little wreath, and one not so necessarily festive. One could be used all year round, but it's a little townhouse. So yeah, I guess you could use that all year round. But we like little houses and villages here at Christmas, and these ones are £1 each, £1.10. And then they also do these little wax stamp sets whereby you've got the little stamp in there, the wax to melt down to use to seal your envelope. So I thought for my Christmas cards, I could use these stamps on the back of the envelope where the seal meets, where the, yeah, you know. Oh, I got a couple more candles in here. Forgot I got these colours. This really nice deep burgundy colour, love them. I actually think I prefer them to the green, you know. We'll see which ones I end up using. And then, oh, this cute little festive decoration. I've got some festive decorations for, again, the tree in here. This one included, £4.84, and it's a little mouse on skis. There seems to be a few things that I've bought with ski poles, holding ski poles or on skis. Manifesting a skiing trip coming up soon, maybe. And then I've got these tags. The gold one in particular I really like, and then there's little gold bits on the holly as well. Oh, I got these. I thought they might come in handy for any like small awkward shaped things. They're just a set of three different Christmas boxes. Can you see it's like a townhouse design with gold foiling? Really pretty. They were only £2. I got some tea, some cinnamon apple tea, my favorite kind of flavor tea, especially at this time of the year. Oh, I got some cute glass baubles. So yeah, for the fun tree, we've got a little red car. This actually looks very similar to the car that Tom actually bought me a car when we first kind of started dating, so that I could go back. I mean, it was in his name, but I used it. I was on the insurance and I was like the first, whatever it was. But yeah, he basically bought me a little Citroen C1, which I'd had in the past as well. This is more of a Fiat, but anyway. I just thought that could be a fun little cute memory to have. And then this, because we love our cinema nights and movie nights even at home, little popcorn decoration. That one was £3. The car, the little car was £2.88. They're always really random prices in here. I got a couple of wooden trees just to pop out maybe on top of a couple of coffee table books or something. I really liked the dark wood of this. So £1.94 for the small one. £4.12 for the large one. Anything else in here? Another glass bauble. We've got a little, how much is this? £3.16, and it's kind of like a cute little gingerbread house, little festive house with snow on it. I also got this little candy cane one. All the fun decorations for this tree, £2.06. These ones aren't glass, but this one is £2.62 and £2.62. There was a third design as well, but I just got these two in a beige and burgundy candy cane and little bell. So that is everything I got from Sostra, I think. Anything else in there? No. More of these napkin rings. Let me see how much the napkin rings actually were. Eight of them at £2.72. So yeah, not too bad at all. That's everything I got. So in terms of the monthly favourites, with it being the first video of the month, it's been quite haul heavy, so everything that I've bought this month has been my monthly favourite. But I did have a couple of recommendations for TV and also a book, Finished Verity, Colleen Hoover. Oh my god, guys, you have to read it. It's so good if you like a thriller. My mind is quite active and I read quite, like, all my books I tend to read usually are thriller based. So I think it could have even been stretched a bit further with a bit of a bigger twist. But it was still really well written. I flew through it and loved it. So I would recommend that. For TV, I'm a celeb. Hands down. That and The Traitors are my favourite reality TV. And that's the dishwasher finished. Did you hear it pop open? It pops open when it's done. Yeah, so I thought I would shout that out. Oh, I did watch a thriller the other day on Netflix. What was it? I was by myself and I was a bit like, oh, is this going to be a bit scary for just me by myself? I think it was called, let me Google it, like Trapped In or something. Locked In. It's a good one. It's essentially about this woman who seems to have had, oh my God, there's a huge squirrel in the garden on the tree. I've never seen a squirrel that fat before. It's like barely pulling itself up. Anyway, this woman who lives in like a really like manor, beautiful, beautiful house, very well off. She is hospitalized, can't move, can't speak, can't do anything. And the nurse ends up getting her to communicate through blinking, through showing her a letter board so that she can kind of spell out words, and she spelled out the word murder right at the start. So the nurse basically has to, it goes back in time as well, figure out what's happened. And yeah, I found it really interesting. And then the other thing that I watched on Netflix that I was gonna recommend to you guys was called Twin Flames. And it's one of these documentaries that they do. I think it's three parts, so it's fairly easy to binge. And it's essentially following this kind of cult ideology, try and get that word right, around the term twin flames, which is essentially, I would say, like a soulmate, meeting your soulmate. But they really encourage you to follow and chase your soulmate. And this, you know, people, it's showing real footage and everything of video calls that they set up, in life meetups that they do, and this organization that they follow still exists, still is a thing. But yeah, I think a lot of people have left it realizing it's a bit too extreme, essentially stalking mannerisms of getting your twin flame to fall in love with you. But yeah, it was worth a watch again and really enjoyed it. But that's everything that I had to recommend to you guys as kind of monthly favorites. I feel like this video is long enough to close off our Vlogmas episode one. Stay tuned for more to come. I might throw the odd video haul here and there, but otherwise they'll be within vlogs, anything new that I get to share with you, because we all know I like to shop till the drop. I just love it. And I hope a load of you guys are with me on that too. But yeah, I hope you guys have enjoyed our first episode of Vlogmas of 2023. Stay tuned for more by subscribing and hitting that notification bell. Have a lovely rest of your day, guys, and I hope to see you all very, very soon in my next video. Bye, guys.